3 Photoshop AI tricks that everyone should know in 2023. The first trick is how designers are enhancing their player images to look like this. Go up to Filter and go into Camera Raw Filter. If you click on the Presets tab on the right hand side, you can do a number of things like enhance eye color and even add texture to your player's hair. Another preset that I love to use is the whitened teeth, and sometimes I like to enhance the clothes. We aren't quite done yet. We'll want to add this preset called Pop. This is going to brighten your subject on a ton. I used to make all these changes by hand and it used to take me 30, 45 minutes, but now you can do it in a matter of seconds. You can see what the before and the after looks like right here. But that's just step one. We now are going to duplicate this layer by right-clicking or control-clicking on the layer and then finding Duplicate Layer. Let's go back into Camera Raw Filter and we can find one more preset to change the colors of our subject. Photoshop has a ton of these presets, so feel free to mess around and see which one looks best for your graphic. For me, I'm going to go with FT09 under the Futuristic Style category. You can also add a sharpening preset. I usually keep this as a separate layer so I can change the amount of opacity a little bit later on. Here is what we had before, and here's what we have now. For the last step, we can do our normal Camera Raw filter adjustments of adding clarity as well as texture. The other adjustments I make were for this player specifically, and it definitely could be different for your player. But adding clarity and texture is a must for any of your designs. Something that you guys should try is increasing the whites within your photo. If you have a player that's wearing a white jersey, it's going to make it a little bit brighter and it's going to tend to stick out a little bit. And after you've done that, you should be good for any player adjustments. This is the before and here's the after. Photoshop introduced AI to its platforms and it changed the whole game. You now can take the lasso tool and select an area you want to change and type into its generative fill box to tell Photoshop what you want on the picture. For example, if I wanted to put an object into Jokic's hands, all I have to do is type in the box whatever I want. So for example, if I'm creating a Halloween themed graphic, I can tell Photoshop to make him hold a pumpkin instead of the ball. It's a really easy process that gives graphic designers a quicker way to edit pictures. And this process can be repeated all around the graphic by just highlighting different areas and then telling Photoshop's AI what you want. This is going to save you hours of time and effort. Adding a pumpkin and creating a shadow so it fits in the picture usually takes around 10 to 15 minutes, and Photoshop's new generative AI fill does it in less than 5 seconds. This next tip is super useful and takes seconds to learn. Say you have an image that doesn't fit the dimensions that you need for your project you're working on. See how I have all this blank space above and below my picture? Photoshop has a fix for that. Select the Marquee tool and then drag it across the white space, but make sure you include a little bit of the actual picture. This is so AI will know what to duplicate, and it should give you a full image instead of the half image that you started it out with. Now let's get a little creative. Take your crop tool and extend your picture vertically. Now you can take that marquee tool that we just learned how to use and do incredible stuff with Photoshop's new AI. Just hit generative fill and then type in whatever you want, and Photoshop is going to change the entire picture. Generative Fill will also give you 3 options, so if one looks a little bit funky to you, you always can see what the other options are like. Something that I've done recently is NBA draft night posts, so you can take a headshot of the guy that you're drafting and then put him into a suit in a matter of seconds. Now that you know how to add to a picture, as well as change the entire composition of a picture, you should also know how to take away from the picture. It's a pretty similar process. All you have to do is take your lasso tool and select your subject that you want gone. For example, this is a pretty iconic photo from a very famous race, but if we want to get rid of the USA runner in the background, all you have to do is select your subject and then hit generative fill and remove subject. And now you have a brand new picture. If you guys enjoyed today's video, subscribe for more tips and tricks.